Okay, so guys, since we're close to the end of the semester, today lecture is going to be a little bit different. It's going to be a little bit more interesting. So we're not going to actually use PyCharm, Python, and the ChatGPT API like usually, but instead we're going to use third-party tools to build chatbots. Also using the ChatGPT with AI integrations. Okay, so you know that in real life, when you're actually building something, you don't always use just basic Python or basic Java, but also sometimes you're using third-party integration tools which are with no code or little code that you need to write. Okay. And today I will show you exactly tools like this that can help you build a chatbot, deploy it, and eventually you can give it to a customer and they can put it in their website. This is exactly the chatbot that appears on every website when you go. In the bottom right corner, there is an icon, you press it and you start chatting, right? They are all built with this or similar tools. Okay. So, there are a few popular tools that you can use for this purpose, and today we're going to explore one of those. We're going to actually explore the BotPress. Have you heard of BotPress before? No? Okay, good. So you learn something new. We're going to use BotPress, with which you can, in a graphical way, create a working chatbot. Okay, there are also other tools as you can see. So there is the Stack tool that you can use to communicate with any type of API without writing complex code, which you can also use on the ChatGPT. And there is also Zapier, which you can also use for leads. For example, if you have a chatbot and you want to lead the person to some purchase page, you can use the Zapier. So, of course, using all of those tools will take time, but today we're going to learn about the most important one, BotPress, and we'll create today a functional chatbot. Okay, of course, in the future, if you want to explore this a little bit more, you can explore all the options of BotPress and also how you can integrate BotPress with other tools, including those that you can see. Okay, so pretty much whatever you're gonna see on this slide, I already said. So BotPress is a third-party tool that is using AI to build chatbots. So you can integrate with this. You can integrate this with natural language understanding. You can also customize chat flows graphically, okay, and also with little code. So today we're still going to write some code, but also we're going to do also the graphical part, so you see the whole process, okay? Here's how we're gonna do it. If you have your own device, you can do that on your own device. You can also do it from the lab computers because everything that we're gonna do is on the web, right? It's online. So open the browser and then I will show you how you can create your account and how you can build your chatbot. Board, I uploaded a few files. Okay, one of them is going to be some part of the code that we're going to use, so you have it for a reference. And also another part is going to be a knowledge base. So this is a text file with questions and answers that will help our chatbot to be a little bit more creative in the answers, you know? Okay, so I'm going to go to this website. So it's just write in Google BotPress, okay? And you can go to botpress.com. And after you do that, just do the normal sign up process. So click sign up. I already have an account, but if you don't, you can just continue with Google. You can freely continue with your
Fitchburg email, for example. Yeah, so you can continue just like any other registration. So then they are going to ask some questions. Just you can complete those like very quick. Hello.
Professor.
Yeah, come in.
Sorry, I was at IT.
Did you get a new laptop? A new laptop you got or something
this
like
that? This was the old one I was on.
Jesus.
The spec is less than what I ordered.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not gonna ship this back.
Yes, good idea. Good idea. Don't let them trick you.
It's ridiculous.
Alright, so no worries. We haven't done much actually. Just go to this website, botpress.com, and today I will show you how to build a chatbot. You know, the chatbot that when you go to a website, you know, sometimes you see in the corner chatbot. So this is what we're going to do today. Okay. Right, so guys, have you created your account? All set? Okay, it is. So after you create your account, you just click create bot. Okay, then you can click open in studio. And I don't know why, but in the beginning, it doesn't allow you to start from scratch. It asks you to start as Learn BotPress, you know, so you can use this template. Are those the ones that I was skipping? Yeah, so once you go to OpenIn Studio, it will just allow you to create like educational. It will not allow you to start from scratch, okay, which is not what we want. So I will still you know, create this bot, but then I will go back to my account. Okay, I will just refresh it. Oh, this is my previous account. Okay. Okay, and I will just create a new bot here once I created the educational one. Okay, so just once you create your first bot, then go back and create a new one so you can use the empty template. So yeah, go back to your screen and just create a new bot, open in studio, and now here you can see that you can select start from scratch. Okay, and then use template. So the idea is that all of this is empty. You just have start and then something is happening in between. So I wait until all of you are seeing this page, and after that we're going to continue. Hello, yeah, no worries, come in. Go to botpress.com and create an account, and we're gonna start from there. Okay. So how many of you are there? So you created it? All right. So before starting, I will tell you what the idea is. So as I said, BotPress is used to create chatbots. So here is a starting point. So this is where the user enters your chat. Okay, and this is the end point. What happens in between, we can create it. So whether the user is going to have different options or we're going to communicate with AI, we will define what's gonna be here in between, okay? And also you can see that right here, you can actually chat with the current chatbot that you created, okay? So for example, here, since I have only one block that is only text, okay, if I write hi, okay, I activate the text here and then I get this message. Nothing else will happen since we have only one block. Okay, the other important thing before starting is that you can publish your bot. You can see right here, you can click publish. Okay, and once you publish it, you can share it.
So once you publish your chatbot, you have a link, which means that you can then put this link into any website. You can create an HTML element into any website, and then the chatbot is going to pop up. So if I click here, share, I will see my chatbot right here displayed as how it's gonna look like. Of course, you can add more designs, but we're not going to focus on the design. Okay. And if I write hi, of course, you're going to get exactly the same reply. Now, what we want to do today is to add some functionality to this chatbot. So our task is going to be to create a chatbot for a yoga school. Okay, so imagine you have a customer and let's say you're managing an agency that is building chatbots. Actually, there are quite a few of them that are using just this application to build chatbots and then sell it to people that have websites. Okay, so you have a customer that has a that is providing yoga classes and has a website, and this customer requests you to create a chatbot. Hello, yeah, come in, no worries. So what you're going to ask the user then to provide to you is going to be a document, and I'll show you what exactly. Okay, so the only thing that you would ask your customer to provide to you is going to be some questions and answers, so you can train the AI to answer questions about the business of your customer. Okay, so this is how the questions and answers would look like. Of course, this is a very small sample, but your customer will provide some specific information for their business, and this will be like, what is the difference between, and those are two different types of yoga, okay? And then there is an answer, and so on and so on. So you can use this file also on the chatbot to add it as a knowledge base, and I will show you how this is done. So you get the task, and now your goal is to build the chatbot and then provide a link to the customer. This is your only goal. And this is what many agencies that are doing those things are doing. So they use that, and then they provide a link to their customers. Okay, so you already saw how we can run the chat. Now it's time to build the different blocks, okay? All right. Okay, so firstly, I'll go here and I'll delete this block. Or actually, you can just modify it if you want. So for now, what I will do is I will remove up here the end block. Okay, so this means our chat ends, and I will leave this block right here, and this will be the first thing that we're going to do. Okay, so let's call this block hello. Okay, so I will change the name to hello, and after that I will write some welcome message from the chatbot. Okay, so let's write here, hello, I am Martin. You can write your name if you want. Your AI yoga instructor. Okay. And after that, if I want, I can also add another text file. So you just need to yep. So this was already there in the first block that we had. Mm-hmm. Okay. But if you want to add it manually, actually let me close that. If you want to add it manually, you just select add card. Okay. And here you can add a text card. Okay, so I will select add card, and then I will select text. Okay, and actually here I'm also going to add a second text block, right? So I write, I'm here to answer every question you have.
Okay. Oh, no, yeah, no worries. Is it working so far? Any issues? Okay, so once you have the text fields in that way, okay, then we can create another card. So let's do add card, and I can add a single choice. Okay, I also move this above the always block. And single choice is something that the user is going to decide what option to select. Okay, so we're gonna add a few options for the user so he can choose one of those. Okay, so here, once I have single choice, I write what brought you here today? Question mark. Okay, and now what I want to also do is to send the answer of the user to a variable. Okay, and I will show how this is done, but first let's add the answers. Okay, so what brought you here today? And you can add a few options. Just for the example, I'll add the options. So yoga training for myself. Okay, is option one, and option two would be yoga training for my parents. All right, so this will ask the user to choose one of those options, of course, and depending on that, later on we're going to provide to the AI this information so it can have different types of choices and display different types of things to the user. Now, after we're done with that, you can select create variable right here, okay? And we can assign the answer of the user to a variable that we can later use, okay? So, I will call this variable who for, okay? So later on, if I write any code and if I use the who for variable, it will have either of the options that the user selected. This is the idea. Okay, so once we're done with that, you can see this always block here, right? And somebody, you ask me what it means, right? So the last block right here, the always, is normally some command that will determine where we're going after the user answers. Okay, so you can imagine that there are a few options. One of them is to create a new block from here once he gives some of the options. Okay, but since we want to add next block, no matter whether we choose option one or option two, okay, we're going to use this always block right here, and I'm gonna make sure that you delete the label here and make sure that the condition is true. This means that no matter what the user answers, we're going to send it to the same block of code, but not different ones. Okay, so once I set up the always block as well, I will then create another arrow. Okay, and once I drag the arrow, you will see this menu and then click create a node. And here we can see that we're having a new node where we can start adding information. So let's create it, and after that I will show you what do we have so far. Okay, so firstly, I write here why you here. Okay, it's just the header of the node, so we're going to add here the users why they are interested in the yoga class. Okay, so let's create a new card, so add card, and then yes, okay, perfect. So we named the new node, and then let's add some card. So the first card that we always want to add is text. Okay, so here we're simply going to ask the user or something, or it will text something to him. Okay, so here I'm not gonna ask him straight the question because we're just going to give the user a few options. Okay, so I will just write "that is great, our yoga program could be a great fit." Okay. Okay, so once we add the text, let's add a new card. And again here, I will add the single choice. So we're going to give the user a few more options. Okay, so firstly, when I add this here, I will write, "Why are you looking to learn yoga?" Question mark. Okay, so here we're going to do exactly the same thing. After we ask the question, we'll give a few options, and we're gonna save that to a variable. Okay, so let's do the first option to be to stay fit. Okay, and the second option would be to improve my health. Perfect. Okay, once we do that, I'm going to select create the variable, and again I'm going to name it in a specific way. So I write Y lessons, for example. Okay. And finally, I will create this always block. You will actually see how it's created now. So select add card and click expressions. Once you do that, you have this always block. Just remove the word always. Okay. And just leave true. Okay, good. So once you're done with that, then we're going to do a similar thing, but now we're going to use what the user wrote already in a very small script to decide what we're going to display to them. Before that, let's actually look at our chat. So you can see if I click right here, okay, I can click on this button to reload the chat, and now let's try to text the chat and see what we have so far. Okay, so I will do here, "Hi, oh," so see here I didn't connect the start with the first node, so let's do that, and I will reload it. So if I write "Hi." Okay, so see, now we see the messages. "Hi, I'm Martin, your yoga instructor. I'm here to answer every question you have. What brought you here today?" And then I will select an option from this block. So let's say yoga for myself. And then no matter what I say, it will send me to this block right here. Okay, that will ask me why I chose to learn yoga. And I will select, for example, to stay fit. And then nothing will happen because we need to implement now the next steps. Right? Okay. So now, from the always, I'm going to create another arrow. Okay, so we will have another node. Okay. And then in this note, I'll write "which yoga." This is how I'll call it. Okay, then I'll select new card. And then I'll click execute code right here. Okay. Okay, so in Blackboard I uploaded a file called code.js, where is all the code that we're going to write here for this exercise. Okay, so open the code.js and then you'll be able to get the code that we need for today. So here is how you can add it. Click on code. Okay, then go to the content of node of code.js and just copy the first, how many, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lines. Those functions, just copy and paste them there, and then I'll explain you what they do. Okay. Yeah, come in. Okay, so what we do here is we simply say if the variable that we already created, so workflow.whilelessons, is to improve my health, then I want to display this message. Okay. If it is to stay fit, I want to display this other message right here. Okay, this is the idea. Pretty simple if-else statement. So I will close that.
Yes.
Yeah. You cannot catch up. Do you need some time to... It's fast? Okay, I'll slow down a little bit. So you can write down, guys. Okay, so this is the hello block, right? Mm-hmm. And the variable is who for. Okay. Yes.
What are the limitations of creating ChatGPT as records?
So the limitation is pretty much how much. Okay.
How do I know if this application falls into a criteria of bots? Like, it seems like we are taking some input from the user.
Okay.
Like multiple choice or anything, and on the basis of that, we are doing some computation and just returning an answer. Huh? Is it something like this?
Yes. Do you ask for this application specific, or you ask in general for the? Okay. So for this application, what you're pretty much doing is you're adding some knowledge base. Okay. So the limitations are pretty much your knowledge base and the knowledge of the ChatGPT, right? So pretty much that's it. Unless it has some like restrictions, you know, like if you write, for example, some questions that violate the privacy, like settings, it's going to break. Okay, so once you write your code here, okay, and make sure that you know all the blocks are like this, okay? So I'm just going to sum up like real quick. So first we start right here, then we say hello to the user, we send two messages, we take their choice, okay, for who are looking for yoga class, okay, and then we're gonna send this always block, so no matter what the answer, we send them to the next one. Then we go to the next block, we'll write this message, we ask the user for two options, why they want to join the yoga class. And once they choose any type of option, we send them to the third block. And in the third block, we have our code. Okay, pretty straightforward. Okay. Now,
This code that we wrote right here, what is going to do it, it will just add some logic on what message is going to be displayed to the user, as I already explained. Now, you probably noticed that when I select the code, you can see that here we have some parameter called next message, okay, which we haven't created yet. So let's do that, okay. So I'm just gonna create a variable. Okay, so select add cart, click text, okay, and here instead of writing a specific text, I will write add, okay, workflow dot next msg, okay, so this is a text block, okay, next message, right? Which means that once the user, you know, select either of those options, you know, to stay fit or to improve their health, then we're gonna display the next message variable, which is going to be either this message or that one. Okay, so once we do that and once we add the code, we can create a new choice card just like we did it before. So I'll add here a single choice, and here we'll ask the user what type of yoga they want to train. Okay, so let's add what type of yoga you want to train, question mark. Okay, and then I'll add a few options here. So of course I don't expect you to be yoga professionals, also I'm not yoga professional, I never trained yoga in my life, but I just researched in Google that the most popular two types of yoga are Hatha, which I don't know if I'm pronouncing correctly, and Vinyasa. Okay, so let's do Hatha. And Vinyasa. Okay. So those will be the options for the user. What type of yoga they want to train, and they are going to give you an answer. After you do that, again we add this always card, we remove always from the label. Okay. And we're all set. And one thing I will do is I will go back right here to the single choice that I had, and I will just create a variable here as well. Okay, so I will do type of yoga, so we can also use this answer later. Okay,
right, so this is the other block that you need to create. It's pretty much the same. Okay, so we have a text field which says that we have a variable, don't forget to change the name to Y lessons right here, and then you have the options, and finally the always block. So it's pretty much the same logic.
Which one? Oh, okay, our yoga program could be a great fit. Okay, then you create the Y lessons listen variable, and the options are to stay fit or to improve my health. Okay, so guys, the ones that you're a little bit behind, continue writing. I will just show the next block, okay? And then I'll come again to help you. Try to, you know, to catch up with this one.
So this is here a text block, and this is the same like questions block, and this is always. Okay, just create this one for the ones that haven't registered yet. Okay. Okay, so the next block that we are going to create is going to be called trial confirm. Okay, so we're going to ask the user if they want to get a trial or they have more questions. This is the idea. So I write here trial confirm. Okay, so here again, I'm going to add a code card. Okay, so I'll add execute code. Okay. And now I'm going to go to the file from Blackboard and I'm going to copy the other code that I have, right? So everything without the first six lines. Okay. So I'll click here and I will just paste it and I will explain you the logic a little bit. It's actually pretty simple. So the logic here in this code is that, you know, we already had the user select multiple variables. So now we're going to use those variables to add some customized answer for the user. So for example, if he selected Y lessons to stay fit, we're going to display one type of message. If the user selected the specific type of yoga, that is Vinyasa yoga, we're going to present another type of message. Okay. So what we're doing here is we're saying, if the who for was for myself, okay, and if the answer to the questions was to stay fit, to Y lesson was to stay fit, then if the user selected the Vinyasa yoga, display this. If the user selected the Hatha yoga, display the other message. Okay, and you can add as many options as you like here. This is the idea. Then here, this else, as you can see, so if the user didn't reply to stay fit, then this means that the user replied that they want to improve their health. So we're going to display different type of messages. Okay? And the same, we're going to create exactly the same copy for if the user selected my parents and if they choose a different type of why they want to learn or different type of yoga. Okay? This is what this code does. Any questions about this? Is it like clear? Yeah? So, yep.
Can you spell something?
Something is burning? Yes, burning.
I think they're having a problem.
Something is burning?
I don't smell it here.
I hope it's not some computer, right?
There's a barbecue or something.
I know that outside there was something.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, here they are preparing for some event, actually. I don't know what is that one. Are you going to participate in the event or something? I mean, if they have barbecue, we can enjoy it, right?
Yeah, I mean, I don't see anyone cooking, but you know, you can see chairs, like speakers and stuff like this. So maybe they prepare something. Okay, so questions you had while we're writing this blog. Can we just... So we cannot do that. And this is the thing, like to implement this, we need to add too many graphical components. So just writing the code is easier. Although this code looks long, it's pretty much a copy paste code, right? Of course, you can add even something more advanced, like you can place those messages in the list to shorten the code a little bit.
Is it in JavaScript?
It's in JavaScript, yeah. So you can, of course, even shorten the code, if you ask me from a professional standpoint. But it's just easier, you know, to write code instead of adding so many blocks. And I'm not even sure if they have the options to, you know, switch between the different statements. Probably this will take a few blocks.
Any other way, like if you just write code, it has to be every block. Means here we are using some blocks, right?
Yeah.
Start, end, like that. Instead of that, like we just give the code.
In the middle.
We just give the design.
Yeah, that could be possible too. Yeah.
Yeah. Does it have to be in JavaScript? Can it be in any other language?
I think it must be in JavaScript in that case. They're just using it there. Okay. But yeah, I think last time we're talking that JavaScript is important, so you see why many applications are using it, okay? But I mean, this is, even with your knowledge from Python, you can you know, understand what this means pretty much, right? So switch case, I mean, we haven't covered it in this class, but it's also something I think you can do in other languages. Like you can do in C++. I'm not sure if you can do in Python. You correct me, guys, if I'm wrong. Maybe you can do it.
Java, this is the same.
In Java, you can do it. Yes. Yes. You know, the break, the if statements, pretty much the same. So, I mean, you can just by going through the code, you can understand what it means. And to be honest, this code you can ask ChatGPT to generate it for you as well, right? Just you can say about the variables, about what you're building, and you get the code. Okay, so it's not something that it's I think the important outcome that you need to get from this lesson is how to build the product, understand the blocks. So let's say if you go to a job interview, you can say, okay, I know BotPress, how to create chatbots. You can create them in that way, you know, you create the blocks, then you can deploy them, and so on. You know, I think this is the important outcome. Okay, so we write this code. Yeah. Okay. Oh yeah, it smells like wood. Okay, so let's focus. Now, this code, based on this code, user will see a specific message based on the commands that they added. Okay, so now the next thing that we're going to do is, firstly, I'm going to add the text here, and also here I will select this next message. So next MSG. Next. MSG, okay, and this will be the message that will be displayed in the code. Okay, so you see here we had next message, and here we do exactly the same thing. Actually, it's workflow next message. Okay. Okay, so this message will be plugged into the code, and this is how we're going to use it. Now, after we're ready with that, now you can see that things will start to get repeated. So we select again single choice, okay? And here is actually going to be the part where we're going to connect the AI, okay? So now we're gonna have a single choice, and here I'm going to ask, would you like more info on how to get started? ? Okay. Okay. So here what? First of all, we're going to create here the first option. Okay. So let's do sure. Tell me more. Or I have a question. Okay, so there will be two options. Okay, so what we want is, if the user select one of the options, we to send the user to the AI. okay? And this is pretty simple to be done. For example, let's say if the user selects, I have a question, okay? So I'm going to drag an arrow, okay? What we want to do is we want to connect with AI and the users to be able to ask this question, okay? So here in this block, I will add a text and I will ask, what is your question? Okay. Yep.
So I'm just curious though, like, for this to be successful, you have to keep it like a closed-ended response.
Yes, correct. You know, however, you see now when we're adding the AI, okay, you can actually implement AI on each of the choices right here, okay? When you add the AI and a knowledge base, when the user, for example, selects the type of yoga they like, you can also have the AI to also give them an answer when they have a choice, okay? And also when they have more questions, you can also have the AI based on the knowledge base to answer those questions, you know? But yeah, so when you're building chatbots for somebody else, you know, in the beginning, you want to lead the users to some specifics for the business, right? You have some goal to send them to a page where they can purchase a plan for the business or to somewhere else, you know? So you need to do those blocks, you know, to guide the users where they go. Okay. Say again?
I said even ChatGPT don't make it open-ended question. Like if you try to talk to their customer care, it's closed-ended response. Like they keep you, your answers are like, you have to pick.
Oh, yeah, I understand what you mean. Yeah.
It's closed-ended conversation, you know?
Yes. Yeah, so in this situation, you really want to keep it like close end, right? So when they ask a specific question, you give them an answer. If you ask straight ChatGPT, sometimes the answers are very vague or they tell you, oh, I cannot tell you for sure. And they give you like many options, right? You don't want specifically that here. Okay, so here, right? Here is where we're going to ask questions. I'm going to also call this block check knowledge. Okay, and here I'm going to add again a single choice, and I'm just gonna name this a variable. So I'll select here, select create variable, and I write question. Okay, and that's it. I'm not gonna do anything else. Okay. So the idea is if the users have question, we need to plug ChatGPT somehow to answer this question. Let's say if the users want to select, you know, sure, tell me more, we can send them to some free trial link or something like this, right? So this is how it looks so far. Now, if the users want to go to sure, tell me more, okay, you can add another option right here. Okay. And this can be trial link. Okay, so here I can add text. And you can say something like, if you join now, there are 50% off. Okay. And then we can say more questions, like if the users have more questions. Yes, no. Okay, and of course if they have more questions, we can send them back to the AI. If they don't have, we can just send them to the end. Okay, so you can see right here, let's say if the answer is yes, so they have more questions, I just take this arrow and I plug it right here to check knowledge again. And if the answer is no, okay, I can drag this arrow and click end because we don't want to chat with them anymore. Yep.
Could you like skip the text and just write, if you join now, they're 50% off, so I don't have like a repeated block. Like,
yeah, you can do that.
I can do that?
Yeah.
Or I can just erase this.
You want to write it in the choice block? Yeah, you can do it.
I don't think.
Okay. So, yeah, if you want to do, you can. Yeah, you can do that. Good suggestion. That will shorten it with one block.
Okay, so I will just leave what we've built so far. Okay. Okay, so where were you? On why you're here? This one?
Yeah.
Okay, so you need to create this, and this one. So those four. Okay, so which yoga, then the trial confirm, and from there you go to either the AI or the trial link. Okay, so those four you need to do. You had a question?
Yeah, the train.
So guys, so Alex told me that there is so when we try to display a message, it doesn't get displayed, so the next message variable doesn't get displayed. Okay, so this is because we don't have it yet here. Okay, so to do that, you can click on variables right here and you can create independent variable. So I will do plus next msg okay. So it's going to be a workflow string, you don't need to change the rest of the things, and I can just write our next message here and click add. Okay, so that hopefully now you can test it. So this should actually create a variable, and so when you display it, it will actually show its value, but not simply next message. Okay. Alright, so now once we have the variables, let's have a quick test if our chat is going to work. So I'll write hi, okay, and then I get those messages: what brought you here, yoga training for myself, why are you looking to learn yoga to stay fit, okay, what type of yoga you want to learn, hatha, let's say, okay. And then you see a personalized message for me, right? So great choice, Hatha classes are best for beginners. So it implies the yoga that I selected, okay? And it says it will improve my fitness and so on. So it also knows that I selected it for improving my fitness as well. Okay, so now you can see that we're in this stage right here. Where I choose whether I want to learn more or I have a question. So if I select I have a question, okay, so see here in the question I will just remove make choice from the list below. So click question and remove this because we are not actually making choice from the list below, but we just keep talking with the chat. Okay, so this is confusing. Okay. Tell me about Hatha Yoga. Okay, so if I write this right here, you can see that pretty much nothing happens, okay? And I want to improve that, right? I want to add some AI, so I don't see this message, but instead I get some personalized answer for myself, okay? So let's do that. Okay, now you saw in Blackboard I added also another file that is called knowledge.txt. Okay, here's the file. What I want you to do is to download the file in your device. So let's see if I can download it. Okay, download it or copy it and paste in a txt file. So we need to have a txt file, and I'll get it from here. knowledge.txt. Okay. So once you have that file, you can add some knowledge to your chat. How do we do that? So here you can see below we have default knowledge base. Okay. And when I click here on the default knowledge base, you can choose how you want to pass the knowledge to the chat. Okay, so I'll click document, and there you can pass knowledge from PDF, HTML, text, doc, docx. So there are a few options. So I will just pass my knowledge.txt file here. Okay, and I'll click confirm. So it will take like a few seconds for this to get processed. Okay, so for those of you who missed it, you click here, then you add a file, okay, a document. So if you have another editing kit, you will see like big icons. Just select document and pass the knowledgebase.txt file. When the chat answers the questions, it uses two sources, the knowledge base and its personal knowledge, okay? But most businesses, they prefer to add knowledge base, actually all of them, because they want some, if you want to add some specifics for your business, let's say we have a yoga class, right? I would add question when the yoga class with trainer Mike starts, right? 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
Okay, so then... Exactly.
Okay.
This is the idea. So when they ask a specific question, you can check the knowledge base and the users can get their answer from there. Okay. Okay. So once you have the knowledge base added, then the knowledge base is actually going to be used everywhere where you see this book. Okay, so see here, you have a book. If I hover on it, you can see chatbot will answer questions from knowledge base. Okay, and even if I hit here, you can see below we have knowledge base, and we have that the chat will answer from the knowledge base, from all knowledge base, in fact. So in normal operation, you can choose which knowledge base you want to activate. Do you want to activate the default knowledge base? Do you have any other knowledge bases? And so on. So, since we have everything in our default knowledge base, we're gonna keep it there. Now, it's very important to understand that you don't really need AI for literally every question that the user asks. For example, here. Who is this for myself or for my parents? Like right here, you don't need the chat to answer anything, okay? But if I leave the knowledge base on, it might answer, okay? So to do that, you can delete search or disable search. And this will remove this book from here, and we no longer will use the knowledge base to answer questions, okay? Now, once we plug the knowledge base, let's try out and see if we're going to actually answer from there. Now, You can see that here on why lessons and on type of yoga, we also use the knowledge base, which usually we shouldn't. We should just use a knowledge base on a question when user asks specific question. But let's run it like this and see what happens. So I'll just try it out. Hi, yoga training for myself. Okay, great, to stay fit. Okay. I choose a type of yoga. Okay, I have a question. And you can see that here we actually answered from our knowledge base. Okay, so when I asked the question, what is the easiest type of yoga? We picked up, you know, some information from the knowledge base. And even if I hover over those numbers here, you can see that they give me the specific information from the knowledge base that were used. Okay, you can also see that we don't specifically write word by word what's in the knowledge base, but we actually write it as an assistant. Okay, so we asked about the easiest type, and here is the complete answer with all the references in the answer. Okay. Okay, now this is how it works. Of course, you can extend this a little bit more. So now, once I asked question, I can also give more options. So, for example, do you have any more questions, right? And if they do, I just return back to the same block, right? So the users can answer multiple questions. But in general, this is the main functionality on how you can actually add AI into your project. Okay. All right.
So Martin, like instead of creating all these, mm-hmm. We just create whatever is the content we have.
Mm-hmm.
We just create knowledgeweb.txt.
Yes.
Okay. We go to bot.press. We go there and we attach a file. Then
mm-hmm.
The bot will create a file.
Yeah. Yeah. So. So yeah, if you just want to use the AI, right? You can just create a knowledge base, okay, and then whatever the user answers, it's gonna be answered from the knowledge base. It's gonna be like just informational content, let's say. So we create all of this because we also want to lead the users through some specific answers, right? So we want to get some specific information from the user. I mean, think about it from a business owner standpoint, okay? Let's say you're creating a business, and when the users go to the chat, you really want the users to go to a specific path, okay? So you want to know from the users what type of yoga they want, like what else we answered, like for who they want it, you know? And you then keep those in some specific parameters. Of course, if you get the answers only from the, if you just create one block, where you ask the AI questions, you don't have the ability to record the user choice in specific variables, right? Because you just have one block asking questions and they just getting answer from the knowledge base. You can do that as well, you know, just for informational purpose. But most of the people that have businesses and have chatbots also want to provide options. And in the real world examples, also at some point you're going to lead the users to some specific page where they can purchase something based on the answers they gave along the way. Okay, so if the answer is okay, I want something for my parents, I'm interested in building my fitness, then you send them to a completely different purchase page, maybe to a group page for them and their parents, you know. So this is the idea of having like all of those blocks, and so you can allocate the choice of the user.
In this one, right, the diagram, right?
The what?
Fetch test, we are having question and answers format, right?
Yes.
So based on the question, it is able to fetch me this answer, right?
Say again? Sorry.
Based on the type of question, it's going to fetch me the answer.
Yeah, yeah.
For
so
the text,
we'll just provide
but in
answer.
This diagrams case, right? In this scenario, like we actually it is storing the question and answers, whatever we are doing.
Yeah. So you're asking if you are controlling the answers that the user is
creating? I mean, in the knowledgeweb.txt, we have like format, like what this for this question, this is the answer, like that, right?
Yes, questions
and answers.
Oh, I understand what you mean. So
if you cannot just these questions and answers in the database, right?
Yeah.
Well, you can, but see how we have different answer choices, right? In the knowledge base, you just have one question and one answer. Okay, so it's a little bit different structure. You don't have like options.
Yeah, but right. Here, right in the diagram, where
okay.
It is storing internally, like for this question, we have to give answer. Like you told, each type of your.
Yep. So, it is storing it right here in those parameters. Okay, and then those parameters, of course, you can allocate them in some database that you have, Excel sheet, something like this. So you have the username, what they like, if they purchased your plan. So you have all the information stored, you know, that the user answered. But yeah, here you store it in those parameters, and then you can use those parameters in the workflow. So you can personalize the experience of the users. More questions?
The options
so it's Heta and Vinyasa, or how it is? Do you know the pronunciation?
Yes.
Vinyasa. Oh, I was close. Okay, nice. Okay. Other questions? No? Okay. Yep.
Like, for example,
yeah.
Like you would want to ask a question, right? Could you have the AI answer that person's question in the chat sheet, like in the format of an AI?
So, those ones, they're also using in the background ChatGPT, okay, to formulate your question, like your answers. So, even though you're passing the knowledge base, they're also using ChatGPT. But, very good question. If you need something specific from the ChatGPT to answer it in the way that we all know, then you can use this tool, Stack AI, okay? And there you can connect to the ChatGPT and then just pass a link in one of the blocks, okay? And this is how you can connect with the ChatGPT. There are really a lot of options, like with this type of content, that you can apply, which, you know, you can explore. As I said, there is also a way to add leads to a web page. So there are applications with which you can create a web page to host, you know, with payment plans, for example. And we just create one lead. And if they say, okay, I want to see the plans, you just connect them to the block where is this link to the lead, you know. But yeah, to your question, yes, you can do that. Yeah, true. And the good thing about this is that you can plug in a lot of tools based on the user choices, okay, and apply them there. Now, so guys, so once you're ready, you can just click publish again, okay, and of course you can now have the link and of course test your chatbot pretty much anywhere, okay? It's gonna be accessible. Okay, share. And here, of course, we can now test the chat, and you can see it looks like just a standard chatbot that you can see on literally every website. Okay. How you can embed that? I can just give you one option that you could do it. When you get the link, you can just create an HTML element to the website. You can add it as an F-frame. You know, there are a lot of options, okay? But this is the link that you need. Then you provide it to the user or just apply it to their website, which is another thing, okay? And this is how it looks. And like this. So I hope, guys, you learned today something new, you know, to add in your resume and to be able to use in the future, you know? So are there more questions about this tool, or we're all set?
So how can we share for everyone?
So I think you can do it with this link. Let me just see. Yep, so this is your link. So if you click share, you know you're going to be allocated to a page. You just copy the link, and then this link can be used pretty much everywhere. Yep.
So
So, also I'm going to elaborate on that. So usually you can, if you pass the link in the ChatGPT and ask what is this link about, ChatGPT most probably will not know, okay, because it doesn't work with real life data. But if you get the link, you pass it to ChatGPT and tell it, okay, hey, this is a link to a chatbot. Create me an HTML file that has this link from a pop-up window in the bottom right corner, that when I click the window, this chat appears from the link, you know. If you do that, you will get an answer that will be either correct and you can just run the code and it should work, like run the code in your browser, or you need to ask a few clarifying questions, you know, but ChatGPT is capable of doing that, okay.
Like make an extra application from this code, from this HTML code. You can just.
Oh yeah. So once you create the HTML code.
That's what I was asking.
Yes, of course,
apparently.
Of course. You can try. I think it should work. And then, as he says, when you create the HTML code, then you can pass this code and say, hey, I want this to be a desktop application. It will create your desktop application. So that should work pretty good. All right, more questions, guys. Okay. Did you like the exercise? How was it? Okay. Nice. Yeah, this it's a new tool, so I saw that it's a little bit hard you know, to follow up, right? But I think in the end you all got good results. All right. So, yeah, I think pretty much this is everything for today. Make sure that you prepare with the next week we have presentations, right? It's our last week. Also I think you can see your grades for now. They are not done yet in Blackboard. So if you want to contact me, something like related to the grades, something that is like, oh, why I have so low points on this assignment and stuff like this, just let me know, okay? And I'll try to help you out with that, okay? All right, so that's everything, guys. Have a good evening.
Thank you.
And try to get something from the barbecue. Okay.